Hi, Signature Associates and friends. Welcome to the Signature Edge Podcast, a podcast dedicated to helping you design an uncommon and impactful career in the business of healthcare. Together, we are making a difference for our clients by lowering the rising costs and administrative burdens associated with great care. Engage with us as we spotlight big ideas to discover an uncommon you through leadership, teamwork, and focus on the healthcare industry. Think deeply, commit fully, and take yourself to the next level of performance.
Hi, friends. Welcome to the Signature Edge. This is Amy Hennings, and I am so excited about the interview we have today with Allie and Scott. We are going to cover what it's like to be an emerging leader, but don't worry, Mark and Chris are going to be back soon. So with that, here's my interview with Allie and Scott. All right, today I am here with two emerging leaders, Allie Bramer and Scott Covert. Allie, Scott, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here. So Scott, I'm going to have you go first. I'd like you to give your name, your title, and a little bit about what you do at Signature.
So my name is Scott Cover. I'm a senior production support lead with ClaimsXM. I've been here 3.5 years, going on 4 in December. And I work on UM support. So I support our nurses and the VA policy team with changes when it comes to prior auths and making sure that they're implemented and attached to claims properly so we can get them paid.
That's awesome. That is big work right there. Allie, tell me about yourself.
My name is Allie Bramer, and I am the creative coordinator here at Signature. And so I am on the experience team with Amy, and I help with facilitation of our events and connection points with associates. I run our social media accounts, just doing all the things to make sure our associates have the best experience they can here at Signature. And I have been with the company a little over 1 year now and just couldn't be happier. And I'm excited to be here with you today.
Oh, that's awesome. Allie. Okay. So you both are part of a program that we just love here at Signature called Emerging Leaders. So I would love to know, and Scott, I'm going to start with you. Did you hear about Emerging Leaders and why did you apply?
So over the years, I saw the emails come across, you know, that it was a program that was offered, and I never really thought much of it until last year when one of my friends, Travis, went through the program. He completed the program and just always talked about how much of a good time he had. So when it came around this year, he kind of pushed me to put my application in, and here we are today.
I love that. I love when people... word of mouth is always the best marketing for our program. So I love that a friend told you about the program and that it was intriguing enough that you wanted to apply and that you got in. I will tell Addison, I don't know, producer Addison, I don't know if the audience knows, we get a lot of applications for emerging leaders and have to pair it back. It is intensive. You have a written application, you have an interview application, and you have to get manager approval. And so it's a really big application process, and then it's a commitment for everybody to, when they apply, to make sure that they put the best foot forward. So Allie, from your perspective, how did you hear about emerging leaders and why did you apply?
So it's interesting for me. I actually heard about emerging leaders before I was even employed with the company. I have quite a few mutual connections here at Signature, and I kept hearing about this program that they offered to help their associates, you know, develop their leadership and professional skills. And that was actually one of my deciding factors to apply to Signature, as I was eager to work for a place that cared so much about investing back into its people. And so here we are today. I was excited to apply. This is the first year that I was eligible. So I was very excited.
Well, congratulations to you both for being part of one of our most prestigious programs. So what I'd be really curious to know is, so you're halfway through the program. So what would you say is one of the biggest impacts it's made in your career journey, in your day-to-day life at Signature?
So for me, I feel like it's just given me more confidence to seek more out. It's easy to get stagnant in what you're doing and just feel like you're treading water. And doing this kind of, it gives you a vessel and a lane to reach out to people and really challenge yourself, you know, look for more to do, find ways to help the company more and do things for the company. So I think that's where it's helped me the most.
Yeah, that's awesome. I know that just sounds Like it just sounds like the signature way, asking more of yourself, look, running to challenges and, you know, seeing how you can bring your best self every day in that ownership mentality. So I love hearing that. That is a great takeaway. Allie, how about you? How, based on what you've done with Emerging Leaders so far, how has it affected your day-to-day life?
It's given me the opportunity to meet so many new people outside of, you know, my regular day-to-day in my normal role. It's created a whole new resource of people for me. So for example, one of the projects that I work on quarterly is our Signature Moments magazine. And one of the best parts about this magazine is getting to highlight our associates' voices. And so I now have an entire new bank of people that I can reach out for this sort of thing. It's just been a really great opportunity to meet a lot of people and hear what they have to do with the company.
I tell you, especially in our hybrid world where we don't have one central place where we all meet and know each other and have a break room where we all congregate occasionally, having those connections, it's harder to make those connections now. So this program, definitely, we hear that every time, that every class that goes through the program, that they get to make a lot of cool connections that they keep for the rest of their time at Signature. So that is, I'm glad you guys are making those connections and learning about each other. So one of the big keys of Emerging Leaders is you get to go and you every week is a different theme and a different course, and you get to have instruction from all across the organization and get to talk everywhere from our CEO and founder to our executive team to all the different teams across the organization and some thought leadership. I think you guys bring in some external speakers and some external thought leaders. I would say, okay, so you've been in this, how many weeks would you say? Probably 18 weeks, would you say? What so far has been the presentation that stuck out to you the most?
I think one of the things that really kind of stuck with me from the beginning is the quote, change the changeable, accept the unchangeable, and remove yourself from the unacceptable. Mm-hmm. And it really just, it's a way to just approach every day. There's going to be things that you can't change, so you just have to accept them. There's going to be things that you can change and you need to make an effort to. And then obviously there's stuff that, you know, if it's not acceptable, you just need to get away from it. I think for me, that was probably the biggest thing so far that I've taken from this.
You're right. There's things that you have to walk away from that are necessary goodbyes, and there's things that you just need better boundaries with. So that's a great, great lesson to have. Allie, how about you?
Yeah, I think Pam mentioned it in our last episode of Edge, actually, but one of my favorite lessons so far came from our Senior Vice President of Talent Acquisition, Suzanne Mata. She presented looking at failure in a new way as a leader and essentially encouraged us to not be afraid of failure and instead look at it as part of our journey to success. You can't be successful without your failures and learning from them. And she also introduced us to the ALA method, which is acknowledge, learn, and adjust, which was basically summarized as not spending more time apologizing than correcting the issue, which I think is super valuable. And that's something that I myself get hung up on sometimes, is apologizing for a mistake or an issue that I was a part of, and instead focusing on how can we correct that moving forward. I think that just really stuck with me.
That's awesome. I got to tell you, that presentation Suzanne gives is always one of the most talked about presentations that that we give. And you're right, Allie, I'm with you. I've been told I apologize way too much. So I think that that's a really great lesson to think about and to really have that moving on and failure's inevitable. And so that is, I think, a really great lesson. I'm glad you had that. I got to tell you, this year was really excited for Emerging Leaders because the experience team got to present for the very first time. And I was so excited to be able to watch that presentation and watch our team shine and be able to share kind of the behind the scenes of what goes on in the experience team. And I think one of the cool things when we get to have different departments talk, I think it really helps people see what excellence looks like in each department. And I think that's a key thing in career growth. You have to understand what is required. What are the cool areas of expertise? How do you become a subject matter expert in that area in order to grow your career? And so, you know, Allie, I would just ask you, let's just take the experience team for a second. What do you think excellence on the experience team looks like?
Well, it's funny. I think excellence, even within our own team, looks very different. We do a lot of different things, whether it's Addison recording and producing this podcast, whether it's me making a social media post, or Taylor, you know, designing a presentation. I think we do a lot of different things. And I think that's what's really cool about our team, is I think you kind of define your own definition of excellence within your role. A lot of our positions are newer, and we've seen a lot of growth within the last year. And so I think we're on this continuous path of deciding what excellence looks like in our role. And that's really exciting. We're constantly, you know, growing and evolving as a whole, which obviously then in turn helps push the company forward as well.
I love that. So yeah, I would agree. Excellence on the experience team looks like continuously improving our work product. I think that I would also say, I sometimes think we underestimate ourselves a little bit. Everyone on our team is a great communicator and has to be able to write and present. And Allie is pretty humble. You have to know design programs and social media programs so that it, so that you can be excellent in how those communications are delivered. You know, Scott, you're on this ClaimsXM team. What does excellence look like on the ClaimsXM team, in your opinion?
I think what we've been able to do with the auto adjudication and being able to meet all the metrics that the VA is looking for and surpass them and continue to do so month after month efficiently, I think that is what our excellence looks like on our side.
Excellence and the ClaimsXM team is like, looks like accounting to me. It looks like just so incredibly complex that I don't think my creative brain would be able to do that, but it's a lot of making sure, as I understand it, that you're meeting all the different requirements and setting up all that automation so that everything flows as smoothly as possible. So that is really important work, Scott. All right. One of the coolest parts about emerging leaders for me that I kind of get to be a part of, but I love watching, is that relationship between the mentors and the mentees. So everybody in Emerging Leaders gets a mentor. So we're going to start with Allie. Allie, tell us who your mentor is and what has that experience been like?
Yeah, my mentor is Josie Rogers. She's in our project management office. And it's been a great ride so far. It took probably one meeting in person for us to really hit it off and set up a really frequent cadence of us meeting. And she's done a great job of, you know, giving me resources and ideas that I haven't necessarily come into contact with yet in my career. One of the things that we've spent a lot of time talking about is leading crucial conversations, which I feel lucky to not have run into major issues in my career this far, but I think preparing for those situations in advance is always a good practice. And she's also just really personable. I think she's had great experience so far. We're both project managers, but in very different ways. So it's cool to hear, you know, how she operates within the company and to hear her experience that led her to this position. So it's been a great relationship so far.
Oh, I love that. I'm so glad you got a chance to bond with your mentor. Scott, how about you?
So my mentor is Zach Fain, who's the chief technology officer, which for me is awesome because I'm a tech guy and I love everything tech. So the big thing for me is, without Emerging Leaders, I don't think I would have had this chance to even meet him, let alone foster any sort of relationship with him. He's a remote guy. He's down in Dallas, which we have a shared interest in. I'm from there originally. I was born down there before, you know, moving to Pennsylvania and then ending up in Omaha. But I went down there recently, so we've talked about all kinds of stuff, Dallas related, Omaha related. And then he's given me some advice, and I've kind of picked his brain about where I want my career path to go. And he's kind of set me up with some stuff to move forward towards that in the future.
I think that is so awesome. I have gotten to be a mentor for 4 years now, for 4 different Emerging Leaders classes. And it is one of my favorite things I get to do each week. But Scott, your thought prompted something. I mean, it is always amazing to me, and we always get stories back, that there's always some really unique connection that the mentors and mentees discover about each other that is just, there's no way we could have paired it for that to even happen. Last year, my mentee, I told her that there was a song that I listened to that I think which would really resonate with her. And we talked about it, and it's discovered it is also her favorite song. It was Vienna by Billy Joel.
Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you?
Well, and she showed me she had it tattooed on her arm. And I was like, I probably do need it tattooed on my arm. We bonded over Billy Joel and of course, leadership and career development and whatnot. But to this day, we still talk about Billy Joel and that song about destiny waiting for you. And I think that is just really, really cool when you get to make those types of connections, especially with people you wouldn't normally get to connect with. So every single one is different, and I love that, getting to know people in that way. And so I'm really glad you guys are having a great experience with your mentor. All right. Last question. For people who are listening to this and going, next year, I got to do that. Applications typically open in January. What advice would you give them? Allie, I'm going to start with you.
I would say just go for it. You know, as Suzanne said, and I talked about previously, failure is only part of your success story. And so even if you're nervous or whatever it may be that's holding you back, I just say, go for it. Like we said, we have a ton of applicants every year. So even if you don't, you know, make it on your first try, I think there's valuable lessons even in the feedback that you'll receive from Melanie and Danji. And so I would just say, don't let it stop you. I think it's a great opportunity, whether you're just starting out your career or, you know, you're a seasoned veteran in your field. I think there's definitely things to be learned from all aspects of the program.
I'll just echo what she said. Just do it. My background is in restaurant management. That's what I did for years. So coming into this, I was curious what it would teach me. And I've learned a lot more than I could have thought of. You know, a lot of management styles are different. And in the restaurant industry, a lot of that's more reactive. You have very few proactive steps and a lot of reactive things you have to do, where this is kind of the opposite. You know, you have a lot more time to plan things out. You can be more proactive in your approach, and you have a little less reactive management style. So it's definitely something I would recommend. If you're interested in doing, just put the application in and see what happens. Because what's the worst that could happen? You know, they're going to tell you no, but they're going to give you feedback, and you can learn from that and then go again the next year.
And what I like to tell people is, what's the best thing that could happen?
Exactly.
I think the best thing that could happen is you're going to be part of a really, really impactful program. Well, Allie, Scott, first, I love getting to know you better today. Secondly, thank you for being active participants in the Emerging Leaders Program and taking part in that and making the commitment to that. It's a big one. And third, I just want to thank you for sharing your story today. So thanks for being on the edge. We'll see you next time.
Thank you, Amy.
Thank you.
Signature Performance is the foremost leader in healthcare administration. Your work, advancing our mission, is transforming healthcare in the U.S. Signature is bringing together the best and brightest in healthcare. Discover opportunities at www.signatureperformance.com/careers and be inspired to build an uncommon career that matters.